Time for another board game review, and this time we have the game Ascension Delirium. This was sent to me by Ultra Pro and is designed by Gary Arant and Justin Gary, the two Garys. Step into another reality. A new portal into the dreamscape has been opened. The world of Vigil is warped by dreams and nightmares come to life. You must wield the power of the Dreamborn to battle back the forces of Delirium to save the realm. Okay, well, I have no idea what any of that means, but this is the first Ascension game that has been reviewed by me. So I'm going to go into basically what Ascension is, and then I'll talk about afterwards what the new features in Delirium are. Let me show you how to play.
So Ascension is a deck-building game where you're trying to get the most honor. And depending on the number of players, you start with a different amount of honor in the honor pool over here. In a two-player game, you would start with 60, and whoever gets the most honor at the end of the game is the winner. Each player starts with a deck of 8 apprentice cards and 2 militia cards. You shuffle this deck up and you draw 5. On your turn, you play cards from your hand. So in this starting hand, it'd be 5 runes. Runes are used to buy cards. And power can be used to defeat monsters. Any cards that you play during your turn get discarded into your discard pile at the end of your turn. And any cards that you buy from the market all get put into your discard pile. So let's say player one buys the Dragon's Eye. They would put this in their discard pile. This would get replaced from the main deck, and they could actually buy another card. So let's say they buy Dimension Monk, then they would put that in their discard pile as well. Now, Dreamborn cards have an effect, but I'll explain that later when I get into the Delirium rules. Right now, I'm just explaining the basic Ascension rules. Like I mentioned before, you can buy cards with runes. This tells you how many runes it costs, so 3 and 2. With the 5 runes I played, I could buy both of these. To defeat a monster, you need to use power. So for Bleak Toad here, I would need at least 4 power in order to defeat it. If you defeat a monster, you get the reward. In this case, you would gain 4 victory points or honor. And you can also banish cards, which I'll explain in a second. Any monsters that are defeated are put or banished into the void and are out of the game. Any cards that are banished are sent to the void over here. And so with Bleak Toad here, not only do you get 4 honor, which you can collect immediately from the honor pool if you defeat it, but also you can banish a card in your hand or discard pile. So if you want, you can make your deck smaller by throwing a card. Let's say I had this apprentice in my discard pile. I could banish it, and now it's out of my hand. And out of my deck, I mean. Once you've played all your cards and done all your runes and power and effects, you just discard all your cards to the discard pile, and then you draw 5 cards. And then this is the next person's turn. As you play cards and defeat monsters, you will collect honor from the honor pool. These are all victory points. And once this runs out, each player has to end with the same number of turns played. So you keep track of who went first, and whenever this runs out, the remaining players each get a turn. You also get honor for the card that you purchased during the game. So the Dragon's Eye here is 2 honor at the end of the game added to your total. And that's pretty much it for rules. You're buying cards and playing more cards and trying to do combos. So let's look at some of these cards themselves. Here is a Dimension Monk that we purchased earlier. Every card has a faction. There's 4 different factions. This is an Enlightened one. There's Enlightened, Lifebound, Makana, and Void. Because certain cards may need you to play certain factions of cards to trigger effects. And the effect of this card is to draw a card when you play it, and you may pay 1 insight to recur. I'll explain what recurring and insight is later, but yeah, that lets you draw a card. You can also play a card called a Construct, like the Dragon's Eye. When you play this, gain 1 insight. Constructs are unique in that they stay in front of you while the rest of the cards you play get discarded. So this is like a little buff that stays in front of you. This has the Serenity keyword, which says once per turn, gain 1 insight. Meaning you gain this effect if there are no cards in your discard pile. So the Dragon's Eye would stay in play in front of you. And anytime you don't have any cards in your discard pile, once per turn, you get a little insight bonus. There are cards that are always available. For example, the Mystic here. This Mystic pile is cost 3 runes to buy, but it gives you a +2 runes whenever you play it. Heavy Infantry costs 2 runes, but gives you +2 power whenever you play that. The Cultist is always here to beat for victory points if you need it. It costs 2 power to defeat it, and you can defeat it multiple times. So if you have like 4 extra power at the end of your turn, you can get 2 honor just by defeating it. And there's no limit to how many times you can beat him, and he always is there. Let's take a look at some other cards here. We got Void Rager. It's a Void hero. Gain 2 power, and the next time you defeat a monster in the center row this turn, you gain an insight. The Dreadmare is a monster. It's 5 power to defeat it, but if you beat it, it's 4 honor and 3 insight as a reward. Divine Ascara. Copy the effect of a hero played this turn. That's very powerful. You may pay 3 insight to copy the chosen effect twice instead, but this effect cannot be copied. This is a Dreamborn card. I'll explain that in a second, but Pollen Pixie just gives you 2 runes and 1 honor each time you play it. And Steel Weaver, this is a Makana hero. Gain 1 rune. Once this turn, when you acquire a construct, put it directly into play. So instead of having to wait to play your constructs, this guy can put them right in there. And you may pay 1 insight to recur, which now let's dive into the new mechanics in Delirium. Insight is a new currency that's been mentioned like 1,000 times already, and you gain these through different ways, and they can be used to trigger different effects. Like for example, Divine Ascara, if you pay 3 insight, you can copy a chosen effect twice. Steel Weaver, you can pay 1 insight to recur. So these can be pretty useful just for triggering different bonus effects on your cards. At the beginning of the game, the first player starts with 0 insight, the next player starts with 1, 2, and 3 for 3rd and 4th and so on. Dreamborn cards, as soon as they're revealed from the deck into the marketplace, every player gains an insight. And also, if you acquire a Dreamborn card, you immediately gain an insight. Recur lets you pay insight to do an ability again. So if I play Dimension Muck and draw a card, I could pay 1 insight to recur it. Then I could gain that effect again, basically draw another card, which is pretty neat. You can only recur once per each card though, you can't keep doing it over and over. That would be ridiculous. Another new type of card is a faked auction card. Let's say this Void Rager got bought and this Shield Bearer enters play. Now, as you can see here, there's a fate auction keyword on here. What this means is, as soon as a fate auction card enters the center row, players may bid insight to gain the effect listed underneath that card, starting with the active player and moving clockwise. So each player must bid at least 1 insight or bid higher than the current bid, and you cannot bid more insight than you currently have. So the effect of this card here is draw a card, and you may banish a card in your hand or discard pile, which is pretty useful. So you don't even have to buy the card, you're just auctioning for this ability. So maybe player 1, the active player, bids 1 egg, but then player 2 bids 2 eggs or 3. Let's say they bid 3 eggs, so then player 1 goes back and goes, nah, I'm okay. Then player 2 would spend 3 insight, and they would immediately get to trigger that ability. And then this stays here until it's purchased. And finally, the newest addition to Delirium is this Delirium Die. During your turn, you may spend 5 insight to roll the Delirium Die, and you gain the effect of whatever is rolled. So let's give it a roll here. Aha, that's just straight up 5 honor. But you can also get 4 power, 6 insight, draw 2 cards, 3 runes, or banish a card in your hand or discard pile. All the effects are pretty nice. So yeah, if you have some extra insight and need certain, like maybe you really need runes or power or something, you can give the dice a roll. Otherwise, that's pretty much it. You're just buying cards and playing them and trying to get the most honor. Here are some other cards, just for an example of what some cards may look like. Here's another Fate Auction card. It's a Vine Weaver. You can just gain 4 honor. So as soon as it appears, you can auction for it, and then if you buy it, you can play 4 honor. Clockwork Blade is a Dreamborn card. Once per turn, when you play a Makana construct, including this one, gain 1 power for each Makana construct you control. So that can be pretty useful if you're focusing on those. Centra Void Mother, gain 4 power. The next time you defeat a monster in the center row this turn, you may acquire a hero without paying its cost and put it on top of your deck. That's pretty nice. I'm not going to go through every single card because that would be ridiculous, but there are a lot of cool cards in here. That's pretty much it.
So first off, let me talk about my thoughts on Ascension in general. I think it's great. Like, people may complain that it's a little too simple, but that's because Ascension is one of the earliest deck builders there is. Like, there's really Dominion, and then one shortly after that was Ascension. And what I love about it is that it's very simple to set up and play. It's refreshingly simple. It plays extremely quick, and also I love that it introduced the idea of the rotating market to deck building. There's no surprise that, like, for me, Marvel Legendary and Clank, those are some of my favorite games of all time. And so, having a market where you can buy cards before your opponents makes for a different tactical experience than Dominion. You never know what's going to show up, and you got to just kind of build your deck as best as you can with what you can grab. So we really have Ascension to credit for that feature, that gameplay mechanic. I personally prefer Ascension and almost all other deck building games, with some exceptions, two player. This makes downtime pretty much non-existent because you're constantly playing back and forth. The turns are extremely quick because it's so simple. What runes you got? Buy that card. You got enough power? Kill those monsters. You can play like three games in a row, no problem. It's very short, like 20-30 minutes, if that, depending on the game. It has that same appeal for me that Dominion does, in that you can just play a really fast, simple games if you know what you're doing. Now let's talk about Delirium specifically. If you don't like Ascension and or other deck building games, then Delirium is not going to change your mind. In fact, I like Delirium overall. I think it's fun, but it does add more randomness and unwieldiness to this game that maybe some purists may not appreciate. But let's talk about what I do like the most. I really like the insight system. Those little orange eggs are really valuable, and I like being able to recur cards and play effects again. That's something that in one of the legendary sets they do that, which I like that kind of idea. And then having little events pop up, like, oh, Dreamborn cards, everyone gets an insight. Oh, an auction appears, let's bid for the effect. It makes the deck just a little more exciting. I welcome that. I think base Ascension can get a little dry, so this adds like kind of like fun little events almost that I like, and having a currency to decide if you want to use it to spend on cool effects is a cool idea. Maybe the most controversial addition to the game is the Delirium die. It's probably my least favorite part, but I don't mind it after playing several games. Once you throw a die in any game, there's going to be uncontrollable randomness. And in some of the games I played, the Delirium die was barely used. In other games, we were constantly rolling it. In the end, I think it's a fun addition. Like, it's always going to be satisfying to roll a die and see what cool goodies you can get. But I'm glad that it's not necessarily a fixture in base Ascension. Like, this is like a fun, like, almost casino flavor of Ascension that I appreciate. If you're a big Ascension fan, this is a really fun set based off the insight system alone. If you're new to Ascension, I don't know if I would start with this one necessarily, but overall it's a fun set. You won't go wrong if you start with this set. It'd be a weird one to start with. I think you should try base set Ascension to see if you even care about this game or this sort of gameplay style. But if you do, this one's fun. It's just kind of like a, like I said, like a casino-y version. I'll roll that die, get these little eggs and spend them and get more eggs. A lot of eggs. It's pretty exciting. I'm sorry.